Pokemon Legends Arceus, it's almost here. One more week and we can get our dirty little hands on this game.
Then we can finally see if Game Freak did something interesting with this game series for once.
I'm pretty conflicted about this game. On the one hand, I'm pretty excited. It's something new. It's probably the biggest change for Pokemon since, well, ever. But on the other hand, the last three Pokemon games were less than stellar. Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee was just not fun for older players. Sword and Shield was such a disappointment. The Wild Area really felt like wasted potential, and it was also such a linear game, even though in the promotions it seemed like it was gonna be a little bit more open world, and I didn't even bother to play Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. So yeah, I'm excited to play this game, but my expectations are really, really low. And I see that there are a lot of people on the internet that are the same way as me, exciting that it's gonna come out, exciting that there's gonna be a big change, but not expecting this game to be particularly fantastic. Which is kind of a shame, because this is really what we wanted since the Switch came out. When Zelda Breath of the Wild just came out, everyone was saying, well, this would be so great with Pokemon. We had these fake screenshots of people basically photoshopping Breath of the Wild with Pokemon elements or Pokemon in there, or like the Pokemon trainer in there. And that looked like a really good idea and a really good fit for Pokemon itself. And now we're actually gonna get it. And I'm just not that excited for it. Which is kind of a shame. So even though my expectations are pretty low, I would like to talk about four things that I would like to see in Pokemon Legends Arceus that would make the game, for me at least, a pretty solid game to play, or even a great game to play. Starting with number four is different difficulties. Now this is probably my least realistic thing, and I don't think we're gonna get it, but still I would love to see different difficulties to make it more interesting for people that have been playing Pokemon games for a longer amount of time. And it's probably not that difficult to implement, just make the AI a little bit smarter or make Pokemon a little bit harder to get, maybe give a little bit less XP, and that's basically it, you don't have to do anything else. There's so many people out there that have been playing Pokemon since Pokemon Red, Blue and Yellow, and these guys are now in their late 20s, early 30s, and the Pokemon games at this moment, they just don't have that much of a challenge. Now again, I know that this is like the least realistic thing on my list, is like asking Dark Souls to have a difficulty slider, and it's just not gonna happen. But still, it would be great to have these options to make it just a little bit harder for more experienced players, without them having to resort to a Nuzlocke or another self-imposed challenge. At number 3 is improved animations. Now what we've seen in the trailers, it does seem like the animations have improved for the Pokemon, and I don't only mean improved animations, I also mean that the Pokemon are a little bit more reactive to you, just so that this world feels a little bit more lively. The animations in Pokemon Sword and Shield were so disappointing, they felt more at home on the 3DS than on the Switch. Now I know that the Switch is not the most powerful thing in the world, but I'm pretty sure you can get a little bit more out of there than, well, this. I mean, for God's sake, Monster Hunter Rise runs on this thing. If they do nail the animations, the world is gonna just feel a lot more alive, and it's just gonna be a lot more enjoyable to go around and even just look at the Pokemon. At number 2 is harder to find Pokemon. Now if you played Pokemon Ruby or Sapphire, you kind of know where I'm going. Phoebus was just really hard to get, I don't even remember how to get it. It was in one particular spot with rain, I think. And even then it was kind of randomly generated. Pokemon Arceus has the potential to do the same thing, with different weather effects, day and night cycle, and different biomes. They can easily implement something similar for rare Pokemon. For example, if you want Dratini, it needs to rain, it needs to be with certain lures, and it needs to be in a specific spot. That would be really interesting and really fun. It makes it so that you have to explore the world good, maybe NPCs can actually give you useful tips to find certain Pokemon, and besides that, it's gonna add a little bit of mystery, which was really missing from the last three games. And at number 1 is an interesting and diverse world. I really, really hope that it's gonna be a little bit like Breath of the Wild, that every spot will be interesting to visit, every spot will be interesting to find something. Again, this game has the potential to be Breath of the Wild, but for Pokemon. So that's kind of exciting, but they really do need to fill this world up with interesting things to see and interesting things to do. There's nothing holding Game Freak back to do weird things like, for example, in Pokemon Sword and Shield you had this mushroom village. Make something like that in this game. I really hope that we get some weird environments, or at the very least some interesting environments to explore. Give us some mountains that look interesting that we can go to. Give us some valleys, some lakes, some caves, anything to explore
and to make exploring just an enjoyable and interesting thing to do. Anyway, those are my thoughts, those are the things that I would like to see. Again, my hopes are very low and I don't think that any of these things are gonna happen, but still, let me know in the comments what you would like to see in this game. If you did enjoy this video, I would really appreciate it if you could leave a like. And if you want to see more like this, then please subscribe. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.